Welcome to DIY Solar and Wind. If you want to make your own electricity, one solar panel at a time, feel free to click on the links down below. Today we're at Gilmore Car Museum. The trucks are going to be taken out within a month. So I just wanted to get up here real quick and get this truck display before they rotate. I don't know, to another building or to another state or what have you. But I like this Coca-Cola truck right here. It's a 1927 Ford Model T delivery truck, Ford Motor Company, Dearborn, Michigan. It is a four-cylinder, it's 3,500 pounds, 22 horsepower, and it sells for only $325. I'm going to read the description for this beautiful truck. See if I can get that right. My camera will not rotate, so we got to play around with it. And you can see with the pedal, you can see through the floor where the accelerator is and where the brake pedal is. You can see right through. So it's probably really cold in the cab in the wintertime. Okay. And I'm going to read it through the distraction. So, delicious and refreshing Coca-Cola. Get the cab. Delicious and refreshing Coca-Cola company advertising. When the first produced, well, it was first produced in 1917, the Model T was sold as a chassis with the buyer supplying the body. It was raised and just short of a ton. The TT was very durable for the same time, but slow when compared. Thank you. When compared to other trucks, the standard gearing, a top speed of 15 miles an hour.
Pretty quick, huh?
Well, that's my place again. 15 miles an hour was recommended, but the Ford was a favorite among companies because of its price, durability, and economical cost of repairs. This particular example features the factory-produced cap and specialty box designed to deliver glass bottle Coca-Cola. Cans did not appear until 1955. Coca-Cola was delivered by independent salesmen in the 1920s and 30s. The truck was designed to carry 72 full cases of Coca-Cola to be sold for 5 cents. Each.
Wow.
Now it's like $1.35. You always knew when the Coke man was coming down the road because you could always hear the bottles clanking away in their cases.
And I've collected beer cans through the years, so
it was always bottles until, where was it, 1955.
Because they had to come up with a plastic liner for the beer cans, okay? Otherwise, the minerals and such within the metal would seep into the liquid. And so when you drink it, it would taste nasty. So they come up with the Kogel-lined cans, so then you could put your refreshments in a can, and it would taste just fine.
So there you have 1955, where they could start doing cans.
Little extra there. And thank you for joining me at Gilmore's Car Museum. Have a nice sunny day.